Good morning, and thank you for joining us here at the opening of this extremely important water treatment plant here in Mandaluyong. It will. Muntinlupa, and it will become part of the system that we are trying to put in place to original purpose for this was not from was really without El Nino in mind, but we have been a little bit lucky in the timing, in that it has been, we will start to operate it just at the time when we will begin to feel the effects of El Nino next year. And so we are very happy that these facilities are already in place. This is one of several that Maynila will be doing, and I thank our private sector partners for coming to the fore and taking up the slack and helping us with making sure that our people have a sufficient water supply. As we know, it is life, and it is, we cannot do without it, and therefore the adequate supply of clean water is clean fresh water is extremely important. So that is what we have done today. Now, if there's anything else that anyone...
Yes. Good morning, Mr. President.
Good morning.
Vivian Gulia from ABS-CBN.
Yes.
Has the proposed 2024 budget reached your table, and when are you expected to sign it? And also, if you are supportive of the push at the lower house to...
Wala pa yata ang report ng BICAM. We're waiting for that. Mm-hmm. So they're putting the finishing touches on it. Baka today. Or the day in the coming days, but certainly the minute it is finalized, then we will immediately, of course, pass the budget. We have been going through the consultations through the whole of the year, for that matter, and I would be very surprised if there are other issues that will suddenly arise that we hadn't anticipated, so or hadn't resolved. Put it that way. So I don't see any problem to that. Yeah.
Before Christmas, will it be? Are you expecting to be
malamang,
signed? Malamang.
Yeah, but you should really ask the BICAM to see what their schedule is. But yes, I think we'll do it before Christmas.
Also, Mr. President, are you supportive of the push at the lower house to amend the 1987 Constitution?
Well, it really, we're just beginning to study. Because we keep talking about economic provisions that are getting in the way with some of the potential investors that we are trying to bring to the Philippines. So what we are looking at here is the opportunity cost of those who would like to invest here, but somehow the laws that derive from the Constitution when it comes to the economic provisions do not allow them to, or make it non-viable for them. So that's the study to see if it requires that, or if we can do it any other way. But in my interest, my primary interest is to try and make our country a investment-friendly place. And whatever we'll see. That's why the study is really not about the Constitution. It's about what do we need to do, what do we need to change, so that these potential investors will in fact come to the Philippines. Yeah. All right. Thank you very much. Good morning. Merry Christmas.